It's common to need a way to access the member variables of a class from code that exists outside of the class. One way you could do this would be to make the variables public and just access them directly. This is sufficient, but there is a better way. That better way is using properties. Properties themselves act like variables and encapsulate member variables, which we can also call fields. This encapsulation gives us a greater amount of control over when and how a field is accessed. Let's say we have a field named experience that exists in the class player, and we want a way for code existing outside of the class to access it. We would want to create a property. The syntax for a property works like this. First, you specify the access modifier. Then, you specify the type, followed by the name of the property. A good rule is to name the property the same thing as the field, except starting with a capital letter. After the name of the property, you place open and closed braces, just like you would for a function. Inside these braces go the property's accessors. A property can have two accessors, get and set. These are the functions that are called when a property is referenced and allocated to, respectively. They're declared using the keywords get and set, followed by braces. Within the get accessor, we return the field that we're encapsulating. In the set accessor, we allocate to the field using the keyword value. That's all that's required to implement a property. Now, in another script, we can use the property in place of the field exactly as we would do normally. You might be wondering why you would go through the process of creating a property when you could have just used the public access modifier for the variable to begin with. There are two things that you can do with properties that you cannot do with public variables. The first is that by omitting either the get or the set, you can effectively make the field write-only or read-only. If the field is private, you cannot read it without a get accessor, and you cannot write to it without a set accessor. The second is that accessors can also be treated just like functions. That means that you could run other lines of code or put calls to other functions inside them. An extension of this idea is to start coroutines using the set accessor. The field encapsulation need not be direct. Consider a game where the player gains experience and levels up after every 1,000 experience points. If you had a field to represent the experience points, you could have a property to represent the level of the player. Instead of returning the number of experience points, the level property's get accessor could return the experience field divided by 1,000. Thus, it would return the numerical level and not the amount of experience the player has. Furthermore, the level property could have a set accessor that receives a level and calculates the amount of experience the player would have and stores that in the experience field. Another feature of properties is that they can be auto-implemented. To create an auto-implemented property, you would use a shorthand syntax. In this syntax, the get and set accessors are followed only by a semicolon. Creating a property in this way makes it behave exactly like a field, the difference being that you can make a property read or write only by removing either the get or set accessor. Using Visual Studio, it's possible to quickly create properties using snippets. If you type prop and then press the tab key, you can insert them automatically.